Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is a quick trick on how to derive age group in Power BI. And if you are looking for how to create range of values or group of values in Power BI, this is the video for you. We are exploring Power BI using a business scenario, Naga Garments. The garments owner having a lot of business questions and he is trying to find answers using a Power BI. Today he got a question like, he wants to know his customer base, whether his customers are kids, youth, mid-age people or elderly people. To know this, he has got only the birth date. So the step one of this process is to get the age for the customers. We have derived the age in my previous video. I recommend just watch it before coming to this video. And today our creating buckets or bins of values or range of values. Let's see it in a demo. If you haven't subscribed this channel yet, hit the button right now to know the tips and tricks like this in future. Let's jump into demo. In our previous video, we have derived age. So let us not have this age as a summarization. Just remove the do not summarize, as it should not be summed up, as I mentioned in my previous videos. So I want to see the age-wise how much quantity sold. Okay, if you see the data like this, okay, so just try to increase the x-axis font so that you can view it better. So fine. So now if you can see the age wise analysis, now you can't able to analyze much from it. I mean, you can see like there is a good customer base from the age group of 20 to 30, 40 to I mean from the 60, 50 to 60s, it is good. But just we want to create age group or bucket dimension so that it will be analyzed much better. So for that, what we need to do is just create a bucket. To create a bucket based on certain column, just click on this age, then right click this option called new group. So this will prompt you one new dialog box where you can specify a list of values and their you can categorize those values into different categories. It's taking long. I don't know why. Let's see. Yeah, there you go. So now you can give a name. Now I don't want bins. Instead, I will go for list. So this will give me all the values, all the ages over here. Okay, so I want to create four groups. So that is between 0 to 13, it will be group one. So just select those first group of values, then click on group. Okay, now I just don't want to type. I'm poor in writing. So let's copy and paste. So this is group one. Then I need to choose another list of values, so it will be till 30s, so 20 to 30, then group. Here I want to choose the give the name as youth. So here on top you need to give the name from 30 to 55, I think. Choose, then group, then give the name as mid-age people. Bear with me. Understand. Then greater than that, I'll say elderly. Okay, there is some people with more than 100 years. That's good. He has got very old customers as well. Let's have it like that. Okay, so I have created four groups. Underneath you have different peoples, okay, different ages, and I've created category for it. just once you're done, just click on age group column, just press OK. So that will create one new column here. I mean, you see like bin of values with that symbol itself different. Now I want to analyze instead of age, I want to analyze with age group. Let me put this chart. I want age group, the same item quantity. Now you see, now you can see from the chart that is most of his purchases happened by you his youth customers and followed by elderly people. So if we create bin of values or age group or grouping of values like this, he can clearly foresee what is his customer base. I hope you guys like this video and share and subscribe to the channel and comment below for the queries. Do remember that data is your asset.